Hi, so today I thought I'd do a quick video about foods that I eat in Rwanda, but I don't eat in the UK, either because they're hard to find or impossible. So here we go.
Sugarcane. So I'm embarrassed to admit this, but before I came to Africa, I had no idea what sugarcane was. It's not something I'd ever heard of. If I had to guess, I'd probably have said it's something you hang on your Christmas tree. But sugarcane is grown all over the wetlands of Rwanda. It looks like a giant stick of bamboo with a thick green outer bark. In season, you see people, especially kids, walking down the road chewing on it, and you can buy it in the shops ready prepared. So the inside is just a fibrous white substance full of sugar water. You chew it and suck out the sweetness, and then you're left with the bark, which you just spit out. In other parts of Africa and Asia, people sell the juice on its own, but you don't tend to see that here. I keep it in the fridge, and it's really refreshing on a hot day. Zingalo. Now, this is considered a national delicacy. Can you guess what it is from the shape? Yep, it's intestines, usually from a goat. It has quite a strong, distinctive taste. When it's done well, it's soft and easy to chew, but when it's overcooked, it can be a bit rubbery. I must admit, it's not one of my favourite foods, but it can be considered rude, especially in the villages, if you don't accept it when offered, because it is the national dish. Goat. So Zingalo brings me more generally to goat. Now, I'm not sure why, but goat just isn't a thing in the UK. We eat a lot of chicken, beef, lamb and pork, but you'd have trouble finding goat unless you went to an African or an Afro-Caribbean restaurant. And I'm really not sure why this is, because goat is really good. In Rwanda, you eat a lot of brochettes, which is just meat on a skewer. But goat is also good in stew, and at celebrations you sometimes see a whole roast goat over a fire. Again, when it's done well, it's melt in the mouth. But sometimes, especially with brochettes maybe in a cheaper resto, it can be pretty chewy. Tamarillo. Tamarillo is a fruit I had never encountered until I got to Rwanda. Here, we call them tree tomatoes. You cut them in half and scoop out the red flesh inside. They're pretty sour, but they're good if you juice them or in smoothies. Just to add to this, I also eat a lot of passion fruit. You can find these in the UK, but they're classed as an exotic fruit, so usually pretty expensive. Here, you can get a kilo for about a dollar. You only used to get purple passion fruit, which we call maracuja. But recently, you can also find yellow passion fruit, which is very mild and tastes a bit more like melon. Isombe. Isombe is basically boiled cassava leaves. It looks and tastes a lot like spinach. In Rwanda, we eat a lot of melange, which basically means buffet, and this is a staple melange dish. Sometimes you even find it at breakfast. It's usually mixed with onions and sometimes meat broth, and I really like it, but it takes a lot of preparation and a long time to cook. Ugali. I think in many parts of Africa this is also known as fufu, but it's basically a dough made by mixing cassava flour in boiling water. Like sugarcane, I had never heard of cassava until I came to Africa, but it's a staple part of the diet here. The cassava plant produces leaves for isombe and tubers for ugali, but the tubers have to be dried carefully because they're poisonous if you eat them raw. You will often see it drying on blankets by the side of the road. So cassava ugali doesn't really smell or taste of much. It's all about the sauce with this dish. You can eat it with beans or meat sauce, and you just tear a piece off, dip it, and down it goes. It's high in calories, so it's a really filling meal. And there's another type of ugali, I think it's made from maize flour, which has a really strong, cheesy smell, and I don't like that one quite so much. But you would think it's super simple to make because it's just flour in boiling water, But to get really good ugali, you have to mash the flour really well, and you need strong arms to do that. Amandazi. When I first came to Rwanda in 2007, there really wasn't much in the shops by way of snacks and treats. You used to buy sweet waffles in greaseproof paper, and these things, amandazi. They're basically fried donut batter. They're slightly sweet and very filling. You sometimes see people selling them in buckets by the side of the road, but you don't tend to see them in shops as much anymore, now that there are more crisps and chocolate bars. But they still go well with a cup of coffee. Tilapia. So the last dish is tilapia, and it's the main fish in Rwanda. A lot of it is imported from Uganda, but there are also fish farms on Lake Muhazi and other regions in the country. In the UK, we generally get cod and haddock when we get our fish and chips, but tilapia is the equivalent here. One of my greatest pleasures is sharing a whole grilled tilapia with friends, because you eat with your hands and you're all reaching into this communal dish. And you usually eat it with ibirai, which is just potatoes, but the way they do them here is to halve the potatoes and fry them, and they're lovely. They're really crispy and fluffy all at the same time. So these are the main foods that I eat in Rwanda, but I can't get in the UK. Let me know if you've tried any of these, or if you'd like to try any of these. And also let me know what your national dishes are.